how worried are you that the critics are not going to like this new movie?
Oh, I'm not worried at all. They haven't liked any of them, really. And they especially haven't liked the last two. So,
well, exactly.
Hey, you know, I mean, it can't get any worse.
Yeah, but come on. I mean, when they go after your writing, your directing, it has to hurt.
Oh, it always hurts.
Did you not say ever to yourself, well, maybe they had a point with this or with that?
The point is, it's like if you paint your house white and somebody comes along, well, that should be a greenhouse. Well, fine, but I wanted to paint it white. I don't think there's anything wrong with painting it white. I don't think there's anything wrong with me for painting it white. Maybe it should be a greenhouse. But I didn't want it to be a greenhouse. I wanted it to be a White House. People come and they say, oh, all this digital stuff, you know, doesn't that make everything phony? Doesn't that make it, you know, it's not true, it's not real. I said, you know, movies aren't true. It's all fake. The story is fake.
Hello.
The characters are fake. The sets are fake. There is no city there. That's not New York City. You go behind it. It's a big piece of wood with a painting on it. And all I'm doing is I've taken it to the next step. And what that came out of ultimately was there is a group of fans from the films that don't like comic sidekicks. They want the films to be tough and like Terminator, and they want to be, you know, real guy movies. And they get very, very upset and very opinionated about anything that has anything to do with being childlike, which the movies are for children, but they don't want to admit that, and or a comic sidekick. They don't want comedy in these movies. And in the first film, they absolutely hated R2 and 3PO. Now Jar Jar is getting accused of the same thing.